Ever since I was a young child, I have always wondered why most commercial aircrafts are of the same two-bit wing design, not other configurations such as a flying wing. In the past, the idea of a flying wing has been experimented with by many aircraft manufacturers. However, most of those projects were killed by internal factors. The German HO-229 was killed by the ending of the Second World War. The American designs were killed by politics. I set off to experiment with the idea of a flying wing freighter. I started by building the design in XFLR-5. I then exported the airfoil used to X-Plane using Java foil. The design is reconstructed in X-Plane's PlaneMaker for flight testing. One of the numerous benefits of the flying wing configuration is the large wing area. This greatly improves low spin handling even at higher payload. This also improves takeoff performance. Notice that both airplanes are using the same engine. Other benefits include less weighted area, reducing drag, and less structural requirement, reducing empty weight. What does all that mean? That means performance improvement. The maximum takeoff weight is increased while the empty weight is reduced. This doubled the useful load compared to the C-130. However, the takeoff performance is also improved. The takeoff distance is reduced by 11% even at higher weight. Still, there's room for improvement. The performance could be improved by the use of newer, better airfoil, a trade secret for most aircraft manufacturers. This design also retains a conventional tail. Better airfoil and fly-by-wire could get rid of the tail, further reducing drag and improve performance.